Well, hey folks, BC7 here, and welcome back to the channel. Thanks very much for joining me here today as we jump back into FS17 and the amazing Kootenai Valley. That fella's got a problem. We're just on our way to deal with it. His problem is he's got about 11 drops of fuel left. So, whoopsie. No problems. Oh, I wanted to check. Just to see what the state of our condition is in. Alright, looks good. I just didn't remember from the last time if I'd been in and done the flatten thing or not. So I do hope everybody's doing well. I know this is going up perhaps a day earlier than expected, but it does seem that the series is still kind of liked by people. So rather than wait anymore, we fire another episode up. So here you go, a Sunday episode. I'm going to have to deal with, I don't know why I didn't just take that other little road up there. Going to have to deal with clearing up the aminals. Looks like the pigs have spit most of their corn out. And I noticed when I first popped in that the sheep were looking a little grassy both inside and out. So we'll deal with that. Yes, we will. Meanwhile, we are off to buy the service trailer from the Mod Hub. Well, from the store, but it's the one from the Mod Hub, of course. And with the aid of that, we should be able to actually finally finish chewing the corn off of that field. And like I say, I'm not going to go another day on it. We're halfway through the day now. Because it's expensive. There we go. There's the little guy. There you go. You just a little, you barely fit. Now, do you have to fill this thing first? This is fuel, isn't it? I think it is. I mean, you know, that would make sense to me. So which is it? Oh, here. Just so we don't explode stuff. Now, which is this going to fill? Me? Yeah. Okay. Now, it is, as you can see from the little picture of the tractor. Was that free? I should get the heck out of here. Apparently, they didn't charge me for that. Be very, very quiet. I'm stealing gasoline. No, actually, So, activate service function. Okay. There we go. Now, can I fill it now? No, apparently not. So, let's unram it. Let's deactivate the service function, and let's go see if it will actually do its thing. Okay. We're out of here. It just doesn't feel like I'm hauling anything. I know it's a tiny little trailer, but still. I would have expected, had we been able to fill it, we would have been able to fill it there. No, I didn't even look at the heads up. Maybe something came up, but... oops. That's all right. We do have, sorry about that. We do have another filler at the farm itself, so... so we get there and it's empty. We shouldn't have to go nearly as far to fill it. And I just don't remember the last time I used this trailer. As I say, it is the one off the mod hub, the Giant's mod hub, so it's been around for a while. And I'm sure we've all used it at one point or another. Because it is, well, the kind of thing that when you're doing work like this, the last thing you want to do is unhitch all of this and then have to go all the way into... Now, which side did it make active? It was that side, wasn't it? Yeah, okay. So... we'll have to approach from the front so as not to scare the prey off. Alright, here we go. Now... I think the way this works is that red square will turn green when there's something in its active range, if I remember rightly. So, okay, the square is now green. Alrighty, let's move the square onto the vehicle in question. That, oops, that should do it. Now, what have we got here in our overheads? Nothing, eh? Okay. You first need to fill the tool. This is not the time to be telling me that. I will break you. We tried filling the tool. Yeah. Okay, kind of what I thought. There's no... there's nothing here to indicate it will fill with fuel. So... I mean, I figured we had to fill this trailer first, it just wasn't cooperating. Yeah, that's the vehicle we've chosen. Service menu, oh, hang on. No, that's not what I want to do. At all. Yeah. Yeah, I really don't understand why you can't just pull the trailer up beside it and fill it, you know what I mean? It says you need to fill the tool, so let's go see what we can fill it with. I don't know. It does sort of reach a point where you just, you know, after a while wish that you would just grab a thing and it would work the way it's expected to work. But we'll see. That doesn't really seem to be the theme for Farm Sim, does it? Oh. Yeah, see, it didn't want to do that. At that other pump, not a chance. It just didn't want to do that. Hmm. All right. Okay, happy, happy, joy, joy. We've now got 1,800 liters of fuel. So if we can get it from here to woohoo. The internals of that other machine, we should be good. Because I wouldn't mind getting on with some other projects, quite frankly. I wonder why it wouldn't fill up the shop pumps. Well, I guess we'll never know, because I'll never take it there again. Alright, let's go do the approach. Alright, well, there doesn't seem to be anything I can do from in here. So, let's see what we can do from here. Anything? This is still just going to bring me that. Yep. Service marker is just that thing. Yep. Service function. Maybe it won't fill. Maybe that's only for the shop thing. Nope. I'm still not getting any sort of fuel-y thing. Figure that would make any difference. Am I maybe just too far away to use it as a fuel source? I know it's in the green window, but who can say? I'm sure at least some of you are yelling at the screen by now, but I don't see that I can get it much closer than that. So we'll try it with the service thing closed. We'll try it with the service thing open. I'm still not getting any sort of fuel thing. I don't see anything in the hub other than disabling realistic fuel usage. No, that doesn't do anything. That doesn't do anything. So, okay. And I still get no fuel, so. So, basically, that was just a complete waste of time, money, and effort. Yeah, like I say, I'm getting really tired of that. Oh, start fuel pump? What? Oh, I see. The fuel marker is on the opposite side of the service marker. That's really nice. Why? Like I said, why don't you just pull up to the thing and get a fillet market, you know? Okay. This had better bloody work this time. Or I will just simply sell it, go back, detach it. There we are. And, yeah. What a pain in the butt. I said, why go through all of that? I mean, you've got a full tank of fuel, even if you use the cheapest, just simple barrel one full of fuel. All you have to do is pull up beside it and hit the refill thing, and it refills. Now I have to figure out when this one's done, then come back out, shut the fuel pump off. Oh, well. I guess they're trying to make it realistic, even though there's nothing attached between the vehicles, so what is the point of trying to fake realism? Alright, we seem to be full. Excellent. Stop the fuel pump. There we go. Alright. I mean, I like I say, I suppose as far as adding some sort of realism to it, right behind it. Yeah. Because you would normally stand where it's going to smash you in the face when you close it. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. I'm glad it works because we needed to get that going, but yeah, it could have been, there is absolutely no need for it to be that complicated. You've already suspended any sort of belief that it's realistic simply by the fact that, like I say, there's no physical attachment between the two units. So, yeah, I'm not sure where they're going with it. But it is helpful. It got us going again without having to drive that thing all the way back in. Instead, we only have to drive to the store and then to the farm and then back over the field. Lovely. All right. That should be about good. I like that the tires actually make noise on the ground. That's kind of cool. Alright, so what I'm going to do here, obviously we're going to re-sow that field, but this one, well, I'm thinking I'm going to go back to grass with it. So, yeah. Let's grab the MB. Well, we're going to have to go get that other trailer dealt with pretty quick. But let's get set up anyways. All right. I'd just stick out a little further than I might be comfortable with. Yeah. Really? Why do I thought that we had kind of moved up from that one to a I know I've got a John Deere for FS19, but I thought I had the one for here as well. Just let me have a quick look about here. I thought we'd upgraded the cedars as well. But it's not kicking around up here anywhere. Don't see one. Don't see anything over here. No. All right, well. I don't know why he just sits there with the head spinning. Goofy hired worker. It's such a nice piece of land back there with the little island and the lakes and stuff. Really nice. Alright, not much more to do. Cooperating. There you go. Gotta be a little firmer on the old button, man. A little overzealous with the backing up thereof. All right. I I wasn't gonna let that stop us. Bouncing around, eh? Okay, this is just a cultivator. Alright. It's not what I want. I was sure I had a John Deere plow. Let's have a look, shall we? There we go, plows. No, I obviously do not. Apparently a 3 meter. That's about the biggest one I've got. Yeah, 1.9 meter. 2 meter. Well, I think what I'm gonna do is unless it got put under cultivators. No. All right, fair enough. Yeah, I'm gonna find the little bit bigger mod and do that. I don't want to do is start building fields with a 3 meter plow. I want to move all of our stuff sort of up out of that range. So, we're at 80%, eh? Well, what do we got there? Looks like we have that little plow. Yeah, that's exactly what that is. Surprised no rocks have popped out yet, considering it's on high. Yeah, I don't mind running this a bit close, because like I said, we're doing grass, so... What we get is what we get, and I'm just fine with it, so... Let's go to... well into here. Nice. Okay, we'll get this edge done. Oops, trailer's full again. That's okay. That's okay, because once I get... Ooh, look, a rock. Once we actually get... the border's done, then I'm going to take it off of Create Fields. And we'll... throw a hired worker on and just let them fill in the, you know, color between the lines, as it were. And go from there. Excellent. This will all be cultivated grass. Okay. Take it off of Create Fields. Sure, we've got lots of nice overlapski. Issues with what's clearly a buried tree. No, they're just going to drop a rock on it and carry on. Loverly. Yes, you are full, aren't you? So you're just going to sit there and spin those motors? Good boy. You learn nothing ever. Good to know. And you're still hooked up, so... Man, it's a lot of, chaff. Nice thing about this big wide pit, we can drop a couple of trailer loads in there without having to worry about the skishing down thing. Because we got lots of room to drop them side by side. Here. Nice. Alright, let's get him back up and running. Sure. We're now even further along in the day. It looks like such a narrow patch, but boy, oh boy, oh boy. It's taken some time. And speaking of time, I think the time for our episode here has just about come and gone. So, I really hope everybody enjoyed. We are nice to be back on the Kootenai map again. And until next time. I love how consistent hard workers are. Take care of each other, folks. And ciao for now. What was the matter with that patch there, hmm? Was there like a birdie landed on the field or what? Good lord. Anyway, guys, take care. We'll see you next time.